Nowadays, live streaming and video calls have become increasingly popular and widespread. Most of the time, people use the viewing cameras on mobile phones, computers, or USB webcams. But for someone like me, who has a DSLR or mirrorless camera like this one, we like having better video quality. We can use either the HDMI output or the USB output from the cameras. In today's video, I will be showing you how to set up your Canon's camera as a webcam using both methods and see which way is better. Let's get started. So this video was made for Canon's cameras only because I am a Canon user. I don't have camera from any other brands to try out. There is many different methods for turning your camera into a webcam. Before making this video, I use camera life and cam twist for the USB methods. If you want to discuss the other methods, please leave your comment down below. I would like to learn more from you. Alright, let's start with the HDMI method. The first thing you need is a video capture card. The video capture card converts the HDMI signal into the computer through the USB port. Then, the computer can use it as a virtual video shot for video recording, live streaming, or video calls. For the video capture card, I am using the Canon 4K from Elgato. You will need an HDMI cable like this one to connect your camera into the computer through the Canon 4K. In my case, I'm using this HDMI cable that has one side is the mini HDMI to connect to my EOS R, and the other side connect to the Canon 4K like this, and then plug it into my MacBook Pro. Now I'm good to go. There is no need to set up anything else. Let's open Zoom and go to setting, videos, and from here you can see me on the FaceTime SD camera viewing from my MacBook Pro. You see how it looks? Okay, and then now from the drop down menu, I can switch to Canon 4K, and this is how I look on the Canon 4K. It's so much cleaner and sharper with a dramatic look instead of the flat boring look from the viewing camera. And open the new meeting. Now I am on the actual Zoom meeting, and this is how I look from the Canon 4K. Actually right now, the signal that I'm sending through the HDMI cable is the 4K signal. And from here, I can switch to the FaceTime SD camera viewing on the menu. And this is how I look like on the webcam. Okay, let's switch back to the Canon 4K to get a better look. Because the Canon support up to 4K 60fps, so depending on the setting of your camera, you could get a 1080p or 4K signal through the HDMI cable. The good thing about this method is that you can do this with any camera brand on Mac or Windows. The downside is you won't be able to get a clean look if your camera doesn't have a clean HDMI output. For example, my Canon M50's HDMI output show all of the settings on the screen. Even if I turn off all of these, the autofocus bulb is still on my face. If I switch to manual focus mode, it will disappear. However, I will lose the dual pixel autofocus. The HDMI output contains the audio, so you can use this as well. Go to Zoom, Setting, Audio, and select Canon 4K from the drop-down menu. By the way, this is just an option. You still can use the audio sources from the menu. Due to the high demands for the Canon 4K from people who are working from home, the price went up like 2 times and it's out of stock everywhere. But I found some alternative ones on Amazon. I will put the link in the description box down below. Let's look at the USB methods. Canon has released the EOS webcam utility app to turn Canon's cameras into a webcam using a USB cable. You will need the USB cables that comes with your cameras. If you don't have one, you can buy one. Make sure that it has the right connector to the USB port on your camera. In my case, I'm using the USB cable to come with my Canon M50. Next, you have to download the app from Canon's website. They have separate version for the Mac and Windows. The download links and the link of the compatible cameras are in the description box down below. After installing the app, you will need to restart your computer. Okay, I'm going to try with my Canon M50. Turn it on, switch to the video mode, and then connect the USB cable to the camera and the other side to my MacBook Pro. Now go back to Zoom and go to setting, video, and again you're gonna see my face from the FaceTime HD camera built-in webcam on my MacBook Pro. And then from the drop-down menu, I'm gonna pick the EOS webcam utility beta. And now you can see me from the M50. I can even zoom in a little bit. All right, let's see. Now the M50 is showing a clean video without the focus box on my face. And the dual pixel autofocus is still on. Open the new meeting. Okay, from here you can see that the video quality is so much better than the video from the built-in webcam, but it's not as sharp as the video from the HDMI cable. It's understandable because the image you get from the USB is the live view feed from the camera, which is 1024x576. Now you might question why the resolution is not HD, but the video is so much better than the full HD webcam. Well, that's because of the DSLR or mirrorless cameras. They have the huge sensors and big lenses. Meanwhile, the webcam just has the tiny sensors and lenses. The big downside of this method is the USB output doesn't come with the audio, so you will have to use the built-in microphone or your favorite microphone for the audio. You can use either method with OBS, Zoom, or any broadcast app. Just pick the right method for your type of work or your budget. Personally, I like to use the HDMI method because I like the better video quality. I don't use it just for live streaming or video calls. Sometimes I need to record what happened on the camera LCD for tutorial video. So the video capture card is very useful. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Until next time, goodbye.